The greatest cause of people changing their theology is their own children grow up and abandon Christian sexual ethics. And suddenly, in order to keep their children, they change their view of what the Bible says. Man, you know who loses when you do that? Guys, I'm not trying to be critical. I had a son who left Jesus. He became an atheist, my own son. I want you to think about it a moment. He went to a Christian school. Every morning we had a devotional in our house. He grew up every day having a devotional. He was in one of the greatest youth ministries in the world. I mean, he had the best preacher in the world. Think about it, every Sunday. He had every opportunity to become a full believer. And he not only left the faith as a teenager, he became an atheist. And I have to tell you, you're tempted to want to bend things in order to keep him. Now, praise God, he met someone who discipled him. If you ever want a reason to believe in relational discipling, I'll hold my son up as the primary example. Two guys got hold of him and they discipled him. My son had every resource available. Nobody in the world has had more resources than he did. But it took two men who loved him enough to spend a little bit of everyday discipling. My son now, he's planting a church in Eugene, Oregon. But I want to tell you, yeah, it's a great story. I'm so proud of him. I'm so proud of my son. But I want to tell you, it wasn't always that way, and I was tempted to yield a lot of things because I wanted that relationship. But you know what he told me one time? I told my son, I almost hesitate to say this to you because we have parents like this, and it's so hard that I don't know how to say this without hurting you. I don't want to hurt anybody. These are not easy issues. But I told my kids when they were young, I told both of them, I said, I'm begging you, please never make me decide between you and Jesus, because I will always pick Jesus. I told them that. And my wife hated it when I said it. It just didn't resonate right with her. And my son told me not too long ago, years later, that was one of the best things I ever told him. Because he said, in those hard years, I needed an anchor in my life. I needed to know there was somebody who stood for what he said he believed. And he said, that was one of the big factors in bringing me back to Jesus, is that you didn't fold. You didn't yield. You stood firm and you loved me anyway. I just want you to know, a nonconformist has to make those tough decisions. When you yield on an adult child who abandons Jesus, they lose their last witness. They lose the only person left who can tell them a better way.